A day in the life of the horseman. Well, I tell you, you would think this was embellishment. Telling you it was not. In those days, we were drawing money. We were making money. The company was making money. Jim Crockett had two private planes. We all bought new Mercedes. We bought five at one time at the Mercedes dealership there in Charlotte. Pull our Mercedes up to the private aviation, get out, pull up to the steps of a private 10-seat jet. We'd fly to a Baltimore, Philadelphia, Richmond, Norfolk, wherever it was. Plane had landed, there'd be a limousine sitting there. Jump in the limousine, go to the Marriott Hotel, check in, go to the arena, kick some major league ass, jump right back in a limousine, hit the town, whatever it was, whatever the evening called for, and we lived like Bob Hope. I don't know how life could have been any grander.
I got a real big house on the big side of town in Charlotte, North Carolina. And you know why I let Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard come over to my house and work out in my gym and swim in my pool and dive off my 5-meter board? Huh? You know why? Because they are champions.
You gotta be a champion 24 hours a day, not just inside that squared circle. If you can get a little picture here, Arn, you're really living the life, baby.
And that's what it was. It was an ideology.
Check that watch out, baby. Check that little timepiece.
We'd always wear sport coats and not always ties and stuff, but sport coats and sunglasses and tried to be very GQ and all that kind of stuff.
We felt like we earned it. We worked harder than everybody else. We put in more time than everybody else. We were in a position to carry the company. We did carry the company. And we reaped the rewards.
Flair would get on television, Rolex time this and that. And so I had to go get me a different gold watch with diamond face so I could, you know, try to upstage. And then he'd get a bigger watch and I'd get a bigger car and he'd get a bigger car. Then I got two cars, then he'd get three cars. And you know, we were firm subscribers to he who dies with the most wins.
Woo, let me see that Rolex, Slick Rick. Woo, where's the limousine, Nate?
When you are a star, you expect to be treated like a star, and you can be a little bit... I'll stop there.
You see, I can't help it that I'm a star.
We talked about being the best. We talked about the gold, the glory, the girls, the money, what lifestyle that you could get.
I'm surfing in Hawaii. I'm down at Myrtle Beach laying in the sun. I'm driving around in one of my two Corvettes, or I'm speeding across the Intercoastal in my Donzi 29 going, woo!
We actually preached in some fashion a way to live. It was a doctrine. Of sorts.
We were taking that private plane, and say for a 4-day run, we'd be on the West Coast. Got them. We'd park that private jet in Las Vegas and operate out of Vegas for 4 days. We'd go to the arena in, say, Oakland. We'd wrestle. We'd wrestle 30 minutes. Jump on that plane back to Vegas, drink half the night, get up it with 4 hours sleep, go to the gym, go lay out in the sun all day, back on the plane, back to L.A., wrestle 30 minutes, back to Vegas. Here you go again, gambling all night long. It was just one of those roller coaster rides. If I wasn't 25 years old, it killed me.
The thing that made the Horsemen was that what we talked about on television, we did.
We were just back from Las Vegas, you know, we had the big vacation right there.
When we went to Virginia Beach and went out to the nightclub, I mean, we went rocking and rolling. I mean, you knew the Horsemen were in town. When we went to Chicago, it was, and we got on television, talked about being at the Snuggery, which I don't think the Snuggery's even there anymore on Division Street, but in the mid-80s, it was there, and when the limousine pulled up, we walked in, we did not pay for a drink. Nothing, walked out of there. It was the Horsemen ruled, and they had a wait in line to get into place, and I mean, it was exciting.
The best part of it was, is we really were a legitimate team. It was four guys that really loved being together.
You're the richest and the best. And you talked about it. And see, that is why the Four Horsemen thing stuck.